but I just wanna say, boy, better know all day. I got bumblebees trying to figure out how I got this buzz. All I want is a kiss and a hug. Somebody tell Specsavers I still can't see no love. Days, months, years, blood, sweat, tears. I walk the streets of London facing my fears. And every day's like truth or dare, so spin that bottle. Cause if it lands on me, I'ma stay true to my word. And I don't want any more respect than I deserve. Boy, better know. Big brothers, big mouth, Skepta. We're gonna welcome the host to the stage, the lovely, the legend, Dame Davina McCall. Make some noise!
I say boom, 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 boom,
boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, we've just seen Ben breaking the golden rule of stand-up comedy by not actually telling any jokes. We saw Shabby going absolutely batshit when Big Brother took her lucky hat away from her, and apparently the hat used to belong to her grandfather. Or Wurzel Gummidge, as you might know him. And to be fair on Shabby, without the hat to finish her look, her braces and pantaloons do look a little bit silly. Anyway, it's... Oh! My new hat. Anyway, it's Big Up Your Chest for our brilliant studio guests. First up, we've got a man who was born on Pancake Tuesday. It's Jared Christmas. And sitting next to Jared is a woman who turned down the role of playing Samantha's mum in Sex and the City 2 to appear in Trust Me, I'm a Holiday Rep. It's the beautiful Jodie Marsh. And check out these glammed up sex bombs. It's the Netto Fabulous Big Mouth audience! So, first things first, when I'm down in the dumps, I like to go shopping. You know, maybe buy some new shoes.
Do you know, whenever I feel a bit low,
yeah,
I always think about that woman who got her face ripped off by a chimpanzee. Oh.
Did anyone else notice Mara Hindley sneaked into the house? Mara Hindley gags, they're always good, aren't they? They're always good. Finally, who says the housemates are talentless?
I'm excellent at cunnilingus.
Yeah.
Now, that is a talent, let me tell you. Now, as always, Big Mouth would like to hear from you. So, if you're one of those people sitting on your sofa shouting, bring back Billy Batty! Look, you don't have to suffer in silence. Loads of ways you can get in touch. Details are on your screen right now. Now, listen, he's back. He's a man. He's so futuristic, he's almost in 4D. Ladies and gentlemen, it's Tom Allen!
Thank you.
Nice to have you back, Tom. It's lovely to see you.
Oh,
listen,
well,
how many rams are you running on tonight?
How many barrels?
Rams.
Oh, rams. Two, three.
That's a lot.
I don't know. I've never. How big is a ram? A ram's quite powerful.
It, yes, but rams are powerful.
I've said the wrong thing,
you.
Haven't I? Yeah, really powerful.
Grr. Now, listen, the wannabe doctor flatlined and became the third person to leave the Big Brother house. But before we get down and dissect the big eviction, I just want to talk quickly about the blonde bloke doing the stand-up. Now, Jared.
Yeah.
Fellow comedian.
Yeah.
What did you make of
I was intimidated by him. He brought the heat. It was that Margaret Thatcher line that that saved him, because she's... No, that's topical at the moment. So, you know, it's good that he came out hard-hitting with the relevant stuff. And the mobile home one, that...
What? The mobile home?
Mobile home. I thought the audience was quite generous on him. But the mobile home thing, you know, he waffled it and...
The audience were quite soft on him, but I think that might be because they were expecting him to be so bad.
He talked, though.
He actually...
He talked.
You know, he was better than we all thought he was going to be. So
absolutely.
We were so pleased that we were like, oh, my goodness.
Well, if everyone's expecting shit, you just...
Exactly.
You just
exactly.
have to do slightly better than that.
Good.
Just slightly better.
It's brilliant.
Yeah.
So, listen, do you reckon Dr. Sunshine is going to heal the world and make it a better place, or just irritate the crap out of everyone instead? Jodie, What do you think? What did you think of her?
I feel bad telling you the truth.
But she brings that out of you, doesn't she?
Go on, tell it. She did annoy me.
Tell it.
She did.
But what, can I ask you why? Because I couldn't quite put my finger on it.
I think just attention seeking and spoil a little bit and just... Oh, I don't know. She just, and just harping on about the same old thing over and over, like what I want. If I see her,
if I see her,
I'm getting so excited about seeing her. That's what it is. If I see her tonight, I want to know, like, why would she want to be friends with John James when he was being an idiot to her?
But like, I think actually you more than anybody would know that when you spend a little bit of time in that house, anybody starts looking fit because you're just all like,
I know.
You don't see anyone else.
Well, yeah, but when he's being that annoying, like fit or not fit. I don't care. Just he was annoying and rude to her.
You wouldn't flirt. You would have flirted with.
Oh, you would have been all over him.
You, Tony Marsh. Oh, you would have. Oh my God, Dennis Rodman was much nicer than John James.
I mean, and I was much worse. And I was horrible
on the counter.
I pushed him off. No, no. I let it go on for a little while and then just I pushed him off and went, I don't like it.
Guys, I want somebody to explain to me why Sunshine annoyed so many people. I just talked to her there and I thought, oh, come on, she's not that bad. Go on.
She really didn't appreciate she was in there. Every time it's, oh, my profession. She's on about showing her ass to the like, public. I actually want to see what that ass is about, because at no point did I see her pants at any time.
No.
So I really want to see what those pants have to offer. Because they seem really nice.
I'll ask her tonight, and that's a good point.
Annoying. I found she was over analytical about things, and it didn't make it interesting.
At the end of the day, she was saying to everybody, "Oh, I hope my knicker's not showing; it's going to ruin my career." That's not going to ruin her career. The fact she's fucking nuts is going to ruin her career.
I think. Also, I think I like the way that she was worried about the knickers, but wearing green lipstick.
Exactly.
Singing Lady Gaga all the time is absolutely fine. And as a vegan, not eating vegetables also is going to get you into trouble as a doctor. Now, somebody here was defending her because I quite like Sunshine as well. Yeah, so let's hear some.
Yeah, she was
Sunshine.
Good. I mean, I think you know initially she was a wee bit nippy, but I think she grew on the house. And to be honest, the big mistake tonight is Kiva not going, because that would have changed the dynamic of the house completely.
It would have done. But I'll be interested to see how it changes now that they've stayed, what power that gives them. Anyway, what do the cyberholics out there think?
Well,
what are they talking about?
Very interesting. They largely say the same thing, as you can imagine. Somebody called Aim Zed Jane says, I'm so glad Sunshine got evicted tonight. John James should have threw her back in the pool before she left. She annoys me so much. I didn't hate her. She reminds me a little bit of Blossom. Did anybody remember that?
Oh, yes.
Yeah, in the 80s and 90s.
Good
but,
progress.
So I quite like her because of that. But I don't hate her as much as I dislike some people in the house at the moment.
I think she's quite unique in the fact that you can't put her in a box.
Yeah,
she's
I want to know who gave her that nickname Sunshine, though.
No,
she gave it to herself.
That nickname,
that's
she renamed herself.
When you give yourself a...
And she literally walked into her school. But you know what? I've got used to calling her Sunshine now, and actually to call her anything else would be a bit weird.
What's her real name?
I only want to
get... I'm just going to tell everybody we've got to take a quick break now, but we're going to be back very soon.
Yvonne.
We're all going to carry on talking. But we've got loads more shizzle, including Sunshine stepping out for a big mouth beatdown. I'll see you in a bit.
Don't know where to hide when the cretins put their feet in their mouths.
I used to be able to self-fillet myself when I was younger.
I'm going to lean my hands on your nubs. I'm going to command them to grow. Is that all right with you?
Worry no longer with the Big Brother's Big Mouth Cringe Cushion. Order now and you'll be comforted through cringeworthy classics like Steve's creepy subconscious puppetry perving.
I want to get my fluffy hands on Colin's false boobs.
Yeah.
This grown man pretending to be drunk.
I'm hammered drunk right now.
And, of course, these memorable clangers from Mario.
Mine's massive. I'm sure.
The Big Brother's Big Mouth Cringe Cushion, offering you the comfort of friends you don't have. You loser!
Welcome back to Big Brother's Big Mouth! Danger. It's Jared Christmas.
Hi, thanks.
Is it a bird? Sort of. It's Jodie Marsh. And he's not about the length, he's all about the bandwidth. It's Tom Allen.
Indeed, I am.
And of course, our so, so sexy audience. And I mean so, so, like as in so, so, not so, so. Like that, yeah. So after 3 weeks, the penny finally drops that John James might have been a bit mean to Rachel. Joe's not happy about Green Day's latest chart performance. And Josie has a yeast infection.
Oh, my God, there's a fire in the hole.
Now, before Sunshine joins us on Big Mouth, she needs a quick debrief to make sure that she's ready to face the Big Mouth bear pit. So I think we can actually go across now and see how Sunshine's getting on. Great! So earlier tonight, Sunshine got booted out of the Big Brother house, leaving Shabby and Kiva to love another day. And that's despite them being responsible for the two worst crimes ever committed, ever seen on Big Brother, not swapping a hat for fags and not wanting to be a lesbian. What do these two have to do to get themselves evicted? Well, let's see Shabby in action.
This is Shabby, 24, a relatively harmless, immature, angry gas bag. But on closer inspection, she's a damned horny lesbian. This is the story of what happened when Shabby's emotions were toyed with by a naive and sensitive Irish girl with a flat top. This is what happens when misjudged, unrequited, one-sided lesbian crushes go bad.
Fucking hot!
Shabby and Kiva have been getting on like scissor sisters.
I'm glad we're in the bath.
Sticking up for each other through thick and thin.
I am literally a love-struck fool.
But wait, there's trouble in paradise. Boring housemate Iffy has gone to the diary room to negotiate more tobacco for the group.
You can have the tobacco, Baldy, but in exchange, we want the scruffy squatter's hat.
You're very reasonable. Thank you.
To you or I, it's just a hat. But Shabby is in a proper knockoff. It's a special hat.
There is a multitude of reasons why I don't want to give this hat up.
It's my lucky hat.
Surely Kiva will stick up for her best friend.
I think if it was my hat, I would have just said, Have it.
Kiva's betrayal results in a massive shitstorm.
Fucking hat!
Fuck!
Find this place!
Let's see that again.
Fucking hat! Fuck!
So, if you've been leading a lesbian who has placed all of her trust in you and expects you to protect her special hat when it's been used as leverage for tobacco, just remember what happens when misjudged, requited, one-sided lesbian crushes go bad.
So it's high time we looked at the great Big Brother nomance of Scabby and Kiva. Jared, let's start with you. What's really going on in there? What's going on?
She's amazing, because she raves on that she's really good at cunnilingus, but I don't think she would be, because she just doesn't shut up. Not
but
that
there
I'd,
could be something quite erotic about that.
Maybe. Talking down there. But I liked the bit where they were in tonight, where they were in bed, and she was going, I'm so scared. And basically she was going, I love you, hug me. And Kiva was just sort of going, I want to go to sleep, it's late. And I've had those conversations.
Yeah, that's the thing that's really, like, I want to like her because I think it's really endearing. You know, we've all been in those situations of unrequited love or whatever, but I can't stand her. Like, I literally hate her with all my soul.
But I cannot stand her. I used to be a bit allergic to her and I've sort of warmed to her a little bit.
Because there are times when she's quite genuine, quite sincere, and then I like her, but then she starts talking, and I absolutely hate her.
Okay, Tom, we get the idea. Listen, Jodie, as someone who has, as Ben puts it, dabbled a little bit.
Are you serious?
Do you think?
Why not?
Do you think in any way, shape or form that Kiva's to blame here?
Oh, yeah, she's fully leading her on, I think.
She's a fairy tease.
Yeah, fully. She knows exactly. When she pushed her up against the wall the other night, and when she was kissing all her neck, is full on just total leader on. It's not fair.
There really is.
It's disgusting.
I mean, does anybody here think that Kiva and Shabby might still happen?
No.
Absolutely no way. And what do you think of the whole Kiva Shabby situation?
You could just see Kiva working it the second that she knew she was up for
eviction. That's exactly what I thought.
That was the first time, the little bit of neck work then, you know, before then, nothing.
Nothing at all.
She's another Nori.
But do you know what it's going to do? It's going to win Shabby lots and lots of sympathy.
I agree with what you said at the beginning of the show, is that in that house, everything's, you know, it's all under a microscope, and I think that's why they're together. I think that's why she's playing up to the cameras as well.
They're not together. It's like, hi, I'm Shabby, I quite love you. Hi, I'm Kiva, I don't think I do.
Does anybody think that it's just because Kiva's got a very short, slightly sort of lesbian-looking haircut? And that if she had long, flowing hair, everybody would be looking at Shabby going, she's such a stalker.
We all have friends that we flirt with. What's wrong with
no,
that?
No, listen, I do not snog or try and sort of give a love bite to my just quite good friends.
I don't try and flick her bean either.
Do you know him?
Yes.
I've just met him.
Yeah, exactly. I'd be quite good. He's trying to read, like, yes, I can't even bring myself to say it. It's funny, I can say shit, but I can't say that.
I think that's the phrase of the night.
Go on, wait till I get the microphone to you. What?
Kiva's in an awkward situation. She's got a bond with Shabby. They've got on from the moment they've walked in there. The girl has got a crush on her and she is trying to keep the peace.
But I think...
Because Shabby's fiery, she's got a strong personality and Kiva's just piggybacking on that.
And I also think that Kiva might be a little bit flattered.
I think Kiva is flattered. I think she's appreciating the attention.
Yeah, and any attention is good attention in that house when you haven't had any for quite a long time. Tom, what are the people saying at home? Jared, you can speak after Tom.
What are they saying about Kiva?
Yeah, on Shabby.
About Shabby, somebody called Gemma Maria says, love, Shabby! ! Love the hat, she's so hot, she's wonderful. If she leaves, I'm no longer watching. So, Gemma Maria, we'll lose her.
Wow, I love
Kiva...
Ransom tweets.
Jack is me says, Kiva is boring. If we didn't have the whole lesbian crush gate with her and Shabby, we wouldn't know who she was.
Yes. Well, I think they actually are probably right that Sunshine's gone because she's a bigger personality. What did you want to say, Jared?
I was going to say everyone appreciates a little bit of attention from a dirty squatter.
It's a no-brainer.
It had to be said. Someone had to say it.
Okay, moving on. Now, as we all know, there's only one good reason to go on the internet, and that is channel4.com/Big Brother. But there is some other good stuff as well, including this gem we stumbled across. Now, we all just love Big Brother, but this bloke might have taken things just a tiny bit too far.
Hello, this is Davina McCall. This is a load of people shouting, welcome to Secret Big Brother! PM. Spencer has spent all day hiding cameras around his house. When his flatmate Jamie returns, I'm going to film him without his knowledge. 6:08 PM. Jamie is arriving home from work now. Hi! It's so great to meet you!
Why are you talking that silly voice?
I'm Spencer!
I know.
Seven or 8 p.m. Spencer and Jamie are watching telly.
I was watching that. What are you doing?
It's a task, Jane! Every time this song comes on, we gotta dance to it!
What are you doing?
It's a task, but if you don't do the task, then we won't have enough money for food next week for shopping!
You're being really weird, Spencer!
10:08 p.m. Jamie has gone to the diarrhea room to offload.
Hello, Jamie. How are you feeling today?
Are you enjoying your time in the house?
Jamie, how are you getting on with the other housemate?
He's a fucking dick.
And when I've finished, I'm gonna beat the shit out of him.
2:08 a.m. Jamie is asleep. But I'm awake. Spencer,
what are you doing?
Jamie in the face.
Oh, get out of my room, Spencer. Get out the... Just move out the
flat. You're not allowed
flat.
To...
Thank you so much to the boys from Broken Biscuits. That's very, very funny. So let's talk about the blonde bombshell Ben, who has excelled himself by successfully becoming a joke. Is there nothing he can't do? Well, let's go deep on the posh bloke from Marylebone. Jodie.
It's their pet name.
That's worse than asking if she's a bird. No, I love you. Jodie, are you a Ben lover?
I like him, but I have to say, I'm still holding a grudge against him from
why?
When they, that sticky task, and he was supposed to be, you know, all the sellotape around him, and he went, oh, get me down,
I can't do it. Tasks, is he?
And yeah, and it annoyed me because I just thought, you know, they're relying on you to get more food or whatever it was. And
yeah, look what he did with the Tree of Temptation.
And yeah, and just like, it's just rubbish, and I just think he needs to man up a bit and just put some more effort in. Yeah. And just,
Jared,
you know.
Jared, what's your opinion? Yeah.
He's been an utter disappointment. He came in. No, he has been, admit it. He came and started strong. But he has done nothing but disappoint after disappoint.
Are you upset
about the arm wrestle?
Yes.
How lame was that?
He didn't even try.
Oh, you know what? Jump on someone and wrestle.
I have to say, I liked him, but I've been a bit disappointed the last couple of days. But who's backing Ben? Okay, let's come over here.
Absolutely, Ben's fantastic. He's so entertaining, he's a typical bumbling Brit.
Yes, anybody else over here?
His stand-up was magnificent. Loves James Bond. He's perfect.
He's a perfect housemate. Yes, what do you
think? He's amazing. He's like got a little inner child in him. He's just never going to grow up.
No, okay, that's okay. But I think as a die-hard Big Brother fan, he's got to do the task.
Yes.
What do you think?
I think that when he went in, we had an idea that he'd be a really posh person with no personality, but he's really come out of his shell since.
Well, he's done posh people the world of good, hasn't he? Because we've realised that you might sound like an absolute twat,
I absolutely love Ben. When he first went into the house, I thought, oh, I'm not going to like him. But to be honest, he's now already one of my top five housemates ever.
Really?
Absolutely. He entertains. He makes people laugh. He's so unknowing. I mean, yesterday with the tree, that was hilarious. When it was telling her to man up.
Yes.
Absolutely hilarious.
Yeah,
it's funny. Potential winner. Absolutely.
You think he's going to be a winner?
Yeah.
Tom, what are the people saying on Tinterweb?
They love him as well. Somebody called Dolly Blowflake says, I love Big Ben. What a hoot. And the hair. Well, what can I say? Ding dong. That's what Dolly Blowflake says.
What do you
says.
Think?
I do like him, and I think he is he's an interesting dynamic. He's behaving as we don't expect him to behave, but I'm unsure about his intentions with Mario and with Dave. Because there's a weird thing with Ben and Dave. Like, they seem so tactile.
Can we just discuss that?
Every single minute of the day, all you can see is Dave and Ben.
I think a lot of that.
Which maybe is really positive and really modern.
It's like self-comforting each other.
It's like bonding, like, with chimpanzees or monkeys when they, like...
But I also think, because I am a Ben fan, so I'm talking from a Ben fan point of view, but I also think him lying to the housemates... about the task and saying that he was asked to get rid of all Shabby's hats, which actually he was going to get the suitcases. He was lying. What did you think of that?
I think he's got like a proper vendetta against Shabby because he thinks he's intellectually above everyone in that house.
So you're
Shabby
still getting
is,
on the snob thing.
Yeah, but Shabby's on that level, but she's not as nobbish about
Shabby's
it. We've got somebody over here that disagrees.
I actually think Ben is afraid of Shabby because of when it came with the arm wrestling thing, as soon as she said no, it's a rubbish idea, he decided to push it aside and then he didn't want to do it.
Yeah.
I think he's afraid more.
Yeah,
he wants
everyone
to
laugh. He's scared. Jared, what do you think?
Shabby's probably squatting on one of Ben's properties.
Probably. He's got so many, he just hasn't noticed.
No idea.
He hasn't noticed. Yes, sorry, wait for me to come round with the microphone. Woohoo!
I think what says it all to me is when he, when the bed was coming up and he just stood there, he just laid in there and just gormlessly didn't do anything until he had to come out of the bed. And everyone was just laughing at him, but this is crazy.
He's a funny housemate, isn't he? He's entertaining and he's amusing, but he's just got to do the tasks. Anyway, time for another quick break. But when we come back, Sunshine will have to face the wrath of the Big Mouth audience. It's going to get messy. Welcome back to Big Brother's Big Mouth with Jared Christmas.
Hello.
Jodie Marsh. Bringing a touch of much needed glamour to the studio, Tom Allen.
Oh, thank you.
And of course, our gorgeous audience. How much love have I got for my boy Westwood? I've got mad love, honestly, gangster love. So let's do this Gasolina style. Time for the Big Dog's Clip of the Week.
This is Big Brother speaking. Please come to the diary room. We're riding big with Westwood's Clip of the Week. Let's go in. Go hard or go home.
OK, look, we all know Sunshine's worried about her career being ruined by appearing in Big Brother, but we think, like Leg, Fonseca and Dre, she's got everything it takes to become a great doctor.
She's unconventional. She's no ordinary doctor. She's set to stun the medical world.
I just want to heal people. Conventional medicine? Nah, it's all about fairy dust and crystals.
She's sensitive.
The bad news is you've got bad AIDS. The good news is I've got a new cure. Crystals.
I think it's hypoglycemic. Has anyone got any crisps? Wait, I'm a doctor. It's okay.
Oh. You're not having any.
Scalpel.
I think we're losing her.
Microphone.
She's got the skills to heal your ills. Sunshine MD.
Do you think she looks like Lady Gaga? Let's hope this lot don't want to poke her face. It's Sunshine! Sure you're okay. So, Jared, question for Sunshine.
Why did you give yourself the name Sunshine?
I woke up one day and thought it would be funny.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Has it worked out?
Yeah, I think so.
Nice. Well, I can't imagine calling you anything else now. It would just seem really odd, you being anything other than Sunshine. Yeah. Jodie, have you got a question?
Yeah, I have. I want to know, John James was such an idiot to you at times. Like, from what we've seen at home, like, he was an idiot. You know, he was literally saying, I don't want to speak to you for the rest of my time here.
Yeah.
All of this. Why did you still want to be his friend?
Well, he said that yesterday, but today he said sorry.
But before he did, sorry, you were still saying, I just want to be his friend.
Oh, he is lovely. He does have two sides. He's either the sweetest, nicest person. He's quite sensitive, he'll cry, and he's always stuck up for me. He's stuck up for me a lot with everything.
And what's the
other side, he gets into such moods, and he argues quite a lot.
So he's not always a nice person?
No. If he was the nice one all the time, he'd be perfect.
But he is sexy, though, isn't he?
He's a bit hot, isn't he?
Yeah.
So you do
even in a chicken suit.
Is anybody here? Is anybody here?
Yes, I'm gutted that you're out. Absolutely.
absolutely gutted. We're from OK Magazine, we had a poll, and Kiva was definitely going to go out until the big John James underwear expose saga.
Oh, no, I feel really bad for that. I should have just gone, haha, it was a bit funny. But unfortunately, I'd had a little bit to drink, and at the time, it seemed like the worst thing in the world.
Was it beer goggles? You were just got a bit emotional.
Yeah, well, I did, yeah. I got really, I was just like, oh, the world is over. And then the next day, I was just like, yeah, it's all right. Never mind.
We've all been through that kind of thing
but
before.
But you take yourself so seriously all the time.
Oh, like, so you think some, so?
Sometimes I like the fact that you thought you found life fun, but when something actually came to you, you seem to take it so seriously, like it was so dramatic, like it was the end of the world.
You're fun, but then when something bad happens, you get very, very serious, I think is what you're trying to say. But wait, let Sunshine answer that.
I don't know, I'm Sunshine, but then I'm also quite serious, aren't I, sometimes? But I'm
not usually. Everybody's got to have light and shade, that's okay. Tom,
with Sunshine.
Have you got a question? Sorry.
Sunshine, I've got a question from the information superhighway, as we used to call it, from a person called Solipsistic. I don't know if you know them. They say, Sunshine, were you jealous of Josie's flirtation with John James at all?
No, everyone keeps asking that. I'm not. Josie doesn't really like John James. She might come to like him. But,
do you know what, Sunshine? Yeah. I think you might find she does a bit.
Yeah. But, well, she was saying to me yesterday, she was saying, I don't know why you want to be friends with him. I wouldn't want to be friends with him if I was
you. I think she fancies the pants off.
She doesn't want to be friends.
Listen,
she want to be lovers.
We're just going to move on quickly and talk some more about someone whose influence on the house has been pretty similar to BP's work in the Gulf of Mexico. He's blonde, he's cute, he looks permanently confused, and he's terrorising his housemates.
Confusion by John James. The new fragrance, poor blokes.
Confusion by John James.
Seductive.
I think that you're a really good-looking guy, and I think you're dead hot.
Confusion by John James.
Powerful.
Do you think that John fancies me?
Confusion by John James.
Angry.
Well, that pisses me off. I want to ring his neck.
Confusion by John James.
And now, John James Sport.
Oh, my God. He looks like David Beckham.
When he's in a football kit, I really fancy him.
Confusion by John James. Proper sexy.
That one, isn't it? That is his magnum.
Yeah.
Brilliant. Anyway, this much we know, right? He's Australian. He looks all right in a football kit. I don't get it personally, but I can see why you would. And he's got a fiery temper. Look, Jared, you're almost Australian. Can you please just explain the phenomenon that is John James? Can you just explain it to me?
Well, look, he's a lone wolf. He's trying to run his own game, and people find that attractive. I mean, Australians in general are lonely people. Who else would invent a stick that comes back to you? But John James, he's straight out of Home and Away. He is good-looking, and he lets that dazzle people. He's that confused look.
And then he goes in for the
kill. He's doing the little boy thing, you know, he's looking all confused, and all the girls are like, oh, my God, oh, my God.
Cute, and the hair's all a bit confused.
Yeah, exactly, man. He's going to win it.
No!
Jodie,
you're from Essex, which is the spiritual home of the WAG.
Yeah.
Do you like people that look like footballers? You know, do you think he's misunderstood?
No, I think you're right. He dazzles everyone because I think if you strip away the bleached hair and the hood always up and the angry look on his face and the six pack, I think he actually.
Actually, that sounds pretty hot. Six-pack, angry look. Nice. Listen, what does anybody... Are there big, fat John James fans here in the audience tonight? You are? OK, cool.
I think that people are saying how bad he is and everything, how horrible he is to everyone, but at the end of the day, that's what makes Big Brother entertaining. If you vote out all the dead housemates like Rachel and Jovan, not dead as in, like, but boredom ones.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
Then it makes Big Brother more entertaining.
Did you want to go tonight?
Kiva, because she's not got a personality really. Mm. Whereas Sunshine at least did have some sort of personality.
And it was very, very close. Did you want to ask Sunshine something?
Yeah, Sunshine, I just wanted to ask you, do you think you sound and look like Lady Gaga? Because one, Lady Gaga can sing, and two, Lady Gaga's attractive.
Get out! Get out! That's harsh. That is harsh.
You're rich! You've got nothing to worry about.
worry about your face.
To be honest, I've never gone around going, I'm so hot, really.
You are hot. So, blokes, please back me up. She's lovely. Yeah. And girls. Tom, let's just discuss John James for a moment. Let's get back to John James.
Well, yeah, I find him incredibly boring. And just one of those people who, just because they're good-looking, people have always listened to him. So he's always talked bullshit.
But what about the interweb?
On the World Wide Web. Somebody called Bennington is God.
I know him.
Yeah?
Good guy.
See, good I knew you know him. He or she says, Josie, will she leave JJ alone? Always picking on him. That's all they said. That's all they said, very defensive.
But I think she speaks the voice of reason, because when you guys were just about to start it all off again yesterday, it was quite good she came and diffused it, didn't she? Just stop arguing. Go on, what would you like to say?
I think John James likes Josie, the way that she puts him in his place. I think there was a side where she was kind of like, John James, shut up, and he was like, oh, Josie, like, come back, you know, do you know what I mean? I think he likes that, and Rachel wasn't like that.
That very much because girls really
Rachel was kind of like anything. Yeah, Rachel was like, you know, I think you're really hot, and he was kind of like,
oh, whatever.
But Josie doesn't compliment him like that, so he kind of
I had an idea that John James, when somebody's really positive and happy, he just has to bring them down.
Yeah,
he's a bit mean to Ben. He's always mean to Ben. Mm. And we're all friends, the non-smoking crew,
but that's
and
the colonial thing though, right?
I'm sorry, I'm going to come back to you, Jared. Time for another break now. But, Sunshine, we all know what you think of Lady Gaga. So we just wanted you to sing for us live here on Big Mouth. Are you up for it?
No,
do you know what? That's what we love about you, is that your voice is so good. Yeah. So before you sing, we wanted to send you off up there for a full Lady Gaga makeover. Sunshine Gaga, we'll see you shortly. Moment of your life?
No. I thought it was terrible. I got cans in my hair.
I love the Coke cans in the hair. It's brilliant. Finishing touch. Listen, welcome back to Big Brother's Big Mouth. Still with us tonight, we've got Jared Christmas, Jodie Marsh, Lady Sunshine, Tom Allen, and don't they look lovely? Now, some of them call him Mario, some of them call him Molly, but we just call him the one who wasn't quite good enough to make the starting 13, who snuck in by pure fluke when his name got pulled out of a bin. He's got one massive testicle and he's on the loose. Approach him with caution.
We interrupt this program to bring you news of a degenerate operating in the Elstree area of North London. The assailant lures his victims by pretending to be a super sensitive, all-round great guy, when in reality, he's a grubby little rampant perv who seeks to wear his victims down with relentless sexual innuendo.
I wish I wasn't anal.
I wish you liked anal.
And inappropriate behaviour. Those mainly at risk are hapless public school poshos with four haircuts in one.
Just stick your hand in my pants and we'll be fine.
But please remember, this is an extreme and unusual case. So, don't have nightmares.
Super Mario, can he be trusted? Jared, is he a bit dodgy?
Yeah. Well, that's what those clips made him out to be. Very dodgy.
He, I have to say, I don't know if you feel like this, Sunshine, but I do feel he does a lot of sexual innuendos to Ben.
He loves it.
A lot.
He fancies Ben.
Yeah, I know, but it's like all about...
I love Mario. He's my best friend. I think
best
he's lovely.
Friend.
He's. I was standing honestly, next to him when my name was called, really? And I wouldn't be in there if it wasn't for him, because I didn't really realise it. And I was standing there, he whispered, he goes, Sunshine, that's you. So I would still be standing there, probably.
But he did look up your skirt.
Well, he's just silly like that. He kept poking my carpet burn as well. I kept saying, stop it. He's
can you show us your carpet burn?
Oh, no, it's all dressed up.
Is it in an inappropriate... It's had what?
I can show you. Do you
on.
Want to see? It's got,
yeah, go on. Yeah, yeah.
Okay, hold on.
Yeah,
hold on.
Yeah, let's peel it off. Peel it off. I want to have a look.
Give me a few...
Don't worry, she's okay. A doctor. Okay. She knows what she's doing.
Listen, we're going to keep talking about Mario.
Help her. Help her. You're devil.
I'm squeamish. Down the... Heidi way in the toilet to go through the wardrobe.
Yes, Sunshine, you were right about Mario. He did creep down that slope.
That's why I was crying.
My God, look at that carpet burn. That looks really painful.
Yeah,
stand up to them over there. They want to.
You didn't see the juice on the. Show the juice on the bandage. Show the juice on the bandage.
No.
But Sunshine, very brave. Big round of applause. Now listen. I know that Mario is quite a popular housemate, but is there anybody in the studio brave enough to say they don't really like him? Okay, down here. There you go.
I did like him at the beginning when he was the mole, and then when he suddenly got voted out, he was picked to be kicked out. Suddenly he was on the bed and he's like, I deserve more than anyone else to be in this. I was like, okay, get over it. And he seemed to really like go into himself and he kind of backtracked loads.
I understood that because if I was in that position, I would be pissed off as well.
He kind of backtracks, like, all right then. Kind of...
Layla.
I like Mario, however, it's very obvious. I think he's very needy, very desperate, and if it wasn't Ben, it would have been someone else.
Yes, yeah. He needs to be with somebody.
Loved.
Can I just
cuddled.
Say something? I find it very heartwarming that you, from OK magazine, is on Big Mouth. I just would never expect...
We love it!
It's nice to have you here, Layla. Tom... What do you think about? What do you personally think about Mario?
I like him,
I like
and
him.
I feel he's being led up the garden path a bit by Ben. Like
yes,
Ben's
he
all
is.
Over him,
he
and
is.
All like he's always touching him. And I know we saw like Mario's side of it, but I get the impression Ben loves that attention.
And
I think there's something
a bit
cruel.
What about your guys?
Personally, well, Vicky
your
Draver,
yeah.
She says I didn't like when he said about Corin. She's not intellectual. Well, neither are you, Mister. I've been abducted by aliens. He's weird.
That he gets upset say. When Ben doesn't believe about the aliens.
That's because he loves. That's because he's just. That's his way of showing
talking.
He loves him. I think. Sorry.
They were talking and Ben said something like, "Oh yeah, you'd say I don't like talking to you, but you want to. I want to talk about arts and politics, and you want to talk about aliens and UFOs." I think they've got slightly different interests.
Slightly different interests, exactly. Is there anybody else that you desperately want to win? 45 seconds left. I mean, Dave, can we just discuss Dave?
Awesome! I think if he hadn't won the challenge, that he would be out now.
He probably
and he would have been.
He's
been
up there with Stephen Baldwin.
He's
Baldwin.
Never going to get evicted. If they keep doing challenges, he'll never be evicted.
It's a gay marriage. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I can't.
Yeah. Okay, that is all we've got time for. But before we go, big up the Big Mouth guests, Jared Christmas, and we'll see you next Friday!
Yeah! Well, they call me Big Brother. They call me SKDPTA. Before I start, I just want to say, way better know all day. I've got bumblebees trying to figure out how I got this buzz. All I want is a kiss and a hug. Somebody tells me to save and I still can't see no love. Days, months, years, blood, sweat. I want the sheets of London facing my fears. And every day's like 3-4 days, so spin that bottle. Cause if it lands on me, I'ma stay true to my word. And I don't want any more respect than I deserve. Turn up the TV.
Well, I'm breaking it down for you, baby.
Breaking it down.
Roll around, I can't take no love from me.
That's it, Davina, sing that.
Somebody
rest with me. Check. Cause I'm the king of the town.
Just wait.
brand new single, Rescue Me, get online right now. All you viewers, download this. Out now, Rescue Me, verse 2. Where's all the ravers? Where's all the ravers? Chop! No ceilings, no doors, walk all over the beat, no floors. I tell the hater, I love you loads. Tell the supporter, I love you more. And they say I've changed, but I say I'm making a change. Left the road, made a brand new lane. Still I get no thank you, no round of applause. So I keep on driving, I'm upset but I keep on smiling. I wanna get knocked out, get back on my 2 feet and I keep on fighting. I sacrifice all privacy so I can live my dream, what an irony. Cause now my reality is far from the place I'd like to be. It's the brand new single, all you viewers, get online, download this now. Rescue Me, Boy Better Know, 2010. Yeah! Turn up and tell you, let's sing it! Well, I've been
running around, I can't see no love for me. Somebody rescue me.
We got Mr. Miyagi.